Main event time here in Tallinn, Estonia. Ladies and gentlemen, we are live on Fightbox HD around the world, and this is certainly a main event that could happen literally anywhere in the world. The KOK interim middleweight title is on the line.
Ladies and gentlemen, KOK World Series 2021 in Tallinn, Estonia. We are live, and it's time for the main event of the evening. KOK World Interim Title Match. Blue corner, fighter representing Norway, Andreas Iversen.
Let's do it. This is a middleweight title fight, an interim title fight, that is going to have major implications on the middleweight title scene right now in King of Kings, which is on fire, by the way. We just saw Kamil Ruta in the last event in Poland defeat Yuri Orlovs and most likely become the number one contender for the championship, which is currently held by Daniel Forsberg. However, the winner of this fight is also going to have a stake and a very good reason to get a title fight too. Here comes Andreas Iversen, Andy Candy, as he's known. 16-4 as a professional.
Andreas Iversen, Norway. Ladies and gentlemen, red corner, fighter presenting Estonia, Maxim Vorovski.
And I don't think it would be too big of a stretch to say that Maxim Vorovski, overwhelmingly known as the best middleweight fighter from Estonia, so much experience, 32-5-1 as a professional, was a former student of the late great Ramon Deckers, and has spent a lot of time training under the tutelage of all the great trainers there at Hemmer's Gym. Grew up on the streets in a tough neighborhood and developed into a formidable middleweight fighter in the world of professional kickboxing. Before the fight, he said, "I'm going to do my best to win and to keep the title here in Estonia." Says he's going to try to do it for his family and his fans. And he wants to try to motivate young people here in Estonia to do the same. Vorovski has fought before here in King of Kings against Igor Laupin a long time ago, but man, was that one of the most unforgettable fights in KOK history.
Maxim Vorovski, Estonia. Ladies and gentlemen, now will sound national anthem of Norway. Ladies and gentlemen, now will sound national anthem of Estonia. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. KOK World Interim Title Fight and fighting out of the blue corner. 25 years old, official height 188 centimeter, official weight 85 kilogram. His professional record 16 wins, 11 by knockouts, 4 losses. Champion of Norway, ISKA World Champion, representing Nakmai Gym, Norway. Andreas Andy Candy Iversen. Fighting out of the red corner, 33 years old, official height 180 centimeter, official weight 83.5 kilogram. His professional record 32 wins, 17 by knockouts, 1 draw and 5 losses. Winner of KOK Super Fights, prizeman of international fighting tournaments, representing Team Vorovski, Mosa Muay Thai, Estonia, Maxi Vorovski. Ring referee Konstantin Yermolov. KOK rules, 5 rounds, 3 minutes each.
This is it. This is the main event of KOK World Series in Tallinn, Estonia. Winning the KOK interim middleweight title will earn you a world title opportunity. Iversen 8 centimeters taller than Vorovski and looks every centimeter of it. Cracking low kick there from Vorovski. We've seen Iversen before here in King of Kings. He was a competitor in the welterweight World Grand Prix. And now moving up to middleweight, he defeated Erkan Vero of Turkey in the semis, but lost to the eventual winner of the tournament, Konstantino Nanga, in the finals. Boy, does he look big. Iversen looks a lot bigger than I saw him last time. He's almost dwarfing Vorovski. Vorovski in good shape though, as always. Always very well put together and has a very hard punch. He can really throw his hands. I think that Vorovski can hang with the best in Europe. Former Glory kickboxing fighter as well. And has actually been in the ring with some of the top fighters in the world. He's gonna need to find a way through those long arms and legs of Iversen though. That's the tough part. How do you do that? Well, maybe tag the body a little bit. Oh, and he caught him upstairs as well. This crowd is really losing it here in this fight. So far, oh, a clubbing shot over the top. He is really working the midsection of Iversen. Not a ton of movement out of Vorovski either, and I think that sends a message to Iversen that, like, look, I'm here. What are you gonna do about it? Not going anywhere. Give me your best shot. You can already see that the inside of the lead leg of Iversen starting to turn black and blue from the low kicks of Vorovski. And no doubt the midsection has taken some punishment as well. There's that low kick again. He's striking just above the knee on the inside of the thigh of Iversen. Look out! There's a warning shot.
Time!
Round one down and four rounds left to go in this interim middleweight championship fight. Well, let's go back and take another look here. I think that Iversen started off the round great. But the longer the round went on, you could see that Vorovski was starting to figure out what Iverson's bringing to the table. And he started to capitalize on that. He figured out a way, I think, to take out Iversen. And therefore, I think that the wheels were starting to turn inside the mind of Vorovski. And he's finding a way here. His technique looks on point. He's always got the power. He obviously still has that. And I want to see how things develop here in round number two. Well, I guarantee, even though there's people all over the world in 60 different countries watching on Fightbox HD, there's a few people in particular that I think are watching this fight as well. I bet Daniel Forsberg is watching in Finland. And I also bet Kamil Ruta is watching in Poland, because this fight is going to have a huge effect on the middleweight division. Nice little jab there from Iversen, and again, Vorovski just blasts the body. Well, Vorovski's just like a tank now coming forward. Look at this! Vorovski has closed the gap, and he's really opening up. Almost got caught with a knee there. A lot of people calling this fight the best middleweight in Norway against the best middleweight in Estonia. There's that low kick again. Man, he is really on point with those low kicks. He was working the inside of the thigh, and now he's working the outside. Overhand right lands as well. Nice kick there from Iversen. Andy Candy now going to work. Comes in with another knee. I think that Iversen really needs to take advantage of that reach that he's got, both with his kicks and his punches. He can't afford to let Vorovski get inside on him. That's where he does all of his damage. Keep this kid at a distance and use long-range weapons. There you go. Back him up and keep him backed up. Nice combination there. Well, Nice shot. That's what he needs to do. Stay right there at that distance. Is that low kick?
Time.
End of round two. So things slowly developing here in this five-round title fight. We're two rounds in, and both guys still standing strong. Look at that combination. As long as Vorovski can close the gap, get inside and throw that thunder, it's going to be very good for him. Things are going to work out. Things are going to progress. He's going to wear this kid down and win the fight. Iversen needs to keep the distance. He needs to keep Vorovski away. He needs to be the first one to strike. And he needs, look at those, the size of the legs on Iversen. He needs to take advantage of that. He forgot his mouth guard.
Final round. Fight. Third round.
The referee said final round, but he was just reminded there from the Rytis Kuzmenka that this is a five-round fight. He's still got a confused look on his face. Vorovski coming back. Downstairs now with a right hand. Oh, tricky little uppercut there. Look at how he lowers his left shoulder and then drops the bomb. Iversen needs to get his jab going. There it is. Vorovski's eating some shots at a distance now. Oh, beautiful counter. Do you see how quickly he was able to counter with that left hand? Fires off now with a right. Whoa, he's really bringing the heavy artillery now. Clubbing shot over the top. Referee stepping in there to say something about the clinch. They tag each other simultaneously. Whoa! Coming up on 1 minute now remaining in round number three. Oh my! There's that low kick again. Body kick. Ooh, and Iversen got in a good left hand. Iversen scoring some points there upstairs. Inside 30 seconds already. These two doing a good job of pacing themselves, and there's that powerful shot downstairs. Really popped him. Final seconds.
Time.
All right. Another good round. We'll be right back. Both guys starting to feel the pace of this one as we're three rounds deep and we've got the championship rounds coming up. A very high level fight here between these two. As we move into round number four, anything's still possible in my opinion.
Fighters. Round four.
All right, let's see if business picks up here in round number four. So far, these guys have been doing a great job of pacing themselves. They know that this is a five-round fight. They know that the interim title is at stake. And they know that their future in KOK depends on winning this contest. Man, oh Lord! Look at this! Vorovski putting on a show! I love that hook! Cracking kick there, and now one on the other side. Iverson's taking it though. Everything that Vorovski's thrown at him, Iverson has just taken it. Mixing it up here. Well, they keep playing with fire like this, and we may not see a round five. Look at the movement of Vorovski. Going for it all. Oh, he's looking for the liver there. Well, a little bit off the mark that time. Iverson still giving it back. Iverson, if you look back at round one, he has really slowed down now. Big clubbing right hand there that time from Vorovski. Running out of time here in this fourth round. Almost a sidekick of sorts. Oh my, and that round just decisively in favor of Maxim Vorovski. Round number five coming up. Well, all the credit in the world to both of these guys. They're obviously very well prepared for this contest. But I think Vorovski is ahead at this point. Iversen came out in round number one like he meant business. And it's just been, in my opinion, slowly downhill for him. Vorovski really took control in round number four. But, as I said, both these guys, the best that their country has to offer.
Fighters!
And so it's a first-class fight. It's a world-class fight. There's a lot at stake here. who will emerge victorious as the KOK interim middleweight champion. Mats Vorovski in the red gloves from Estonia. Andreas and the Candy Iversen in the blue gloves of Norway. Here we go, fifth and final round. This should decide it. In my opinion, round by round, Vorovski been inching ahead, but Iversen, big tough guy, if he lands a big head kick or something, he could put the lights out. Ooh. Left hand connects. Oh, the right hand as well. What a shot from Vorovski. Ooh, backs him up with a push kick. Right hand finds the mark. Two jabs now. Doubles up with the left. Vorovski picking up where he left off in round four. Man, that shot has got to be painful. Oh, what a left! But whatever he does, he just cannot drop Iversen. Iversen is double tough. Not much offensively coming from Andy Candy here in round five. Nice left hand around the corner. Time is really slipping away here in this fight. This is another amazing round for Vorovski. Hello. Iversen caught him a couple of times on the chin there real quick. Final seconds now. Another big shot downstairs. Whoa!
Time!
And that's the way it ends. This KOK interim middleweight title fight goes to the judges. Well, in my opinion, folks, I think that Vorovski's got this thing. He just kept winning rounds and chipping away at his opponent. Couldn't drop him, couldn't knock him out. Very tough, Andreas Iversen. But I'm fully expecting a victory here from Vorovski. How did you guys see the fight? Ritas Kuzmenka has the official word, and in just a moment, we're going to call both fighters here to center ring and make it official.
Ladies and gentlemen, KOK World Series 2021 in Tallinn, Estonia. KOK World Interim Title Match. After 5 rounds, by unanimous judge decision, the winner is... Red Corner Maxim Vorovski, Estonia!
There you go, folks. Maxim Vorovski has just made history.